Hello guys, welcome to Hot Ninja Entertainment. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, anytime when they come across this video. And guys, if this is your first time passing through this YouTube channel, don't forget to support this channel by hitting the subscribe button and on the bell icon and share this video. God bless you as you do so, and God bless my subscribers and my followers on Facebook. I know the way we analyze and here now, the way we see the matter, and so we table around. Hello guys, hello people, welcome back to another segment, yeah, with Hot Ninja Entertainment. Greetings viewers all over the world, my correct people. I don't do anything like that. I said, we see the matter. Now, so we take the table round as the report they reach my hand. Now, so I say, brother, they come here. So I don't bring the latest update again from this Biafra man you guys are seeing in this video. So, guys, I will just leave the video to play so that you guys can still watch the video and drop your comment at the comment section what you think about this video. But guys, before we jump into this video, if this is your first time passing through this YouTube channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and on the bell icon, so whenever I drop any video, you will be the first person to see it, and feel free to share this video as well. So guys, without wasting much time, guys, let's drive.
I come out and talk on issues that pertains to Biafrans and other people who are looking for freedom. I listened to Delo Momodo of Ovation Magazine, and he was talking about Buhari, the Nigerian situation, and I saw people sending notes. God bless you, this talk you are leader or whatever, brother, you're saying something. I don't fault what Dele Momodo said. I'm not faulting it. But the point is, you, Ndibo, Biafrans, you should use your senses. Be able to filter when somebody is talking and know the direction he's going. If any man is making any comment about Nigeria being one or trying to bring Nigeria together again, or try to fix things that are going on in Nigeria, that person does not have the interest of the Biafran people in his heart. Because we have been in Nigeria for years. They did not suffer what we suffered. They did not. Look, let me put your mind back. Because even within the Christian faith, you have people who are not grounded in the faith. They just keep following men of God. Because you didn't know the fundamentals, the rudiments of the Christian faith about being repentance from dead works, faith towards God, laying on of hands, baptisms, and eternal life. You just jump into Christian faith, you got born again, the pastor begins to preach to you from a very high dimension. You carry it on like that, you're a man of God. You have no foundation, nothing. Therefore, when they bring different types of teachings and begin to tell you things, that's why Paul said in the book of Galatians that there are people who trouble you with another gospel, which is not another. They preach Christ, but they introduce things that are contrary to Christ. And it is only when you are in the flow that you'll be able to discern and know the one that is really talking in respect to the price Jesus paid on the cross of Calvary. And that thing is happening now with Nnamdi Kanu as he's teaching. When any man comes up and begins to tell you of one Nigeria, he doesn't believe in the Biafran cause. I want to take your mind back. After Ojukwu and Gowon had spoken in Abuli, General Ankara, who was the most senior military officer within the West African sub-region then, mediated on that discussion. He supervised it. They had an agreement in the Bonungante. I have a lot to say today. Even in Wim, well, I'm very, very angry. So I need you to put your mind. You people should listen to Nnamdi Kanu. Try to understand that mindset. Try to understand what you understand. Try to look beyond you want to fight. Look at what that man is saying. He's making sense. And once you understand what he's saying, you'll be able to know when somebody is at variance with what Nnamdi Kanu said, no matter how subtle his language is. When they came back to Nigeria, the agreement, understanding was Gowon should go back as soon as he gets to Nigeria, announce the Abuja Accord. Ojukwu gave him time and told him that if we come to Nigeria, I will be the first person to nominate you to be the head of state and commander-in-chief of armed forces. Ojukwu told him that. It's on record. But when Gowon came, people that stood against that thing, when they heard from him, discouraged him. And I've mentioned to you their names. Among them also was Chief Obafemi Awolowo. He teamed up. Remember, it was Ojukwu who released him from Calabar prison. And he had an understanding that as soon as he was released, he would go and form Oduduwa Republic. Well, Ojukwu formed Biafra. Because we were being bombarded, we were being killed to protect our people. But when he left, he did not go to Ikene. No. He rather went to Lagos and became advisor to the federal government. And that was why, when you hear Mbani Bono and Abu Abu during the war, before this Awolowo thing came, during the war, when Awolowo had convinced Gowon not to carry on with the Abuja Accord, because it was because Gowon wasted time in making his declaration, and Ojukwu saw that there was conspiracy, he came out and made the IRA declaration. Remember, Biafrans were being killed in the pogrom. That is a hero for me. That's a man I respect. And the Igbos used to sing this song. Ojukwu beze Biafra, ekwuru ya n'aburi, Awolowo nwanne Yakubu Gowon, enweghi ike imeri Biafra. Maybe people don't even understand what's going on. Awolowo teamed up with Gowon from the Middle Belt to advance the cause of the Fulanese to fight the Igbos. The former Oba of Benin was part of that conspiracy that misadvised Gowon, who was a very senior servant in civil service, not to agree to the Abuja Accord. They had agreed. Ojukwu said he never mentioned confederation. He was talking about regional restructuring. So we understood from that time onward, listen to me, when Ojukwu was When he left, when we lost the war, he flew through with the, I think that name of that plane is the Grey Ghost or something, that flew to Yamoussoukro. He went and met Humphrey Boigny, because Cote d'Ivoire supported Biafra during the war. The other one was Ethiopia, I think Tanzania, and one other country, Israel. But they didn't have enough strength to defend Biafra, materially or militarily. So when Ojukwu flew into Ivory Coast, if he wanted to sit down and be fed, Humphrey Boigny was his friend. He would have let him stay in Abidjan, like Obasanjo was feeding Charles Taylor. But no, Ojukwu went and lived in Yamoussoukro. And in Yamoussoukro, where I know all these things, because I was a young man there. I've been following the Biafran thing right from childhood. I was 7 years old when the war started. The day Ojukwu addressed the international press, for 70 minutes he held the whole world spellbound, explaining the Biafran issue. I was a small boy. I was listening. And this has been a grief to my soul. What has been done to our people over these years? I only had consolation when I got born again. And that was the only way, the anger that was in me against what was done to the Igbos. I knew I wasn't the person that God was going to raise up to do that. I was waiting for the man that God would raise up. After Ojukwu, and God has raised Nnamdi Kanu up. That is why, if you are against Nnamdi Kanu, it makes me feel very bad. If you are an Igbo man against Nnamdi Kanu, it makes me feel very, very bad with you. Because you are sabotaging the chance God has given us. You raise the man. Now, I'm seem to be digressing because I'm angry. Let me calm down a little bit. I'm very, very annoyed. I have a lot of things to say. Okay. So, when they came back and they misadvised Gowon, Awolowo Let me recall to you again. I'm not saying this thing to raise up bitterness between the Igbos and Yorubas. No, I just want to recall your mind into understanding, especially Igbo people who are too quick at either condemning somebody or praising him without filtering in or without getting enough historical facts. Listen to Nnamdi Kanu, he's a teacher. He teaches like a professor at university. That's why they call that kind of university. It's an institution. Go and listen. Listen to him. Listen to Nnamdi Kanu very well. And let him put such a... So when they misadvised Gowon, he refused to declare. Ojukwu had to declare the Ahia Declaration. Then he went to Ivory Coast, stayed with Humphrey Gwaini. He went to Yamasokoro. You know what he did? He went and he bought tippers. When they give him contract, those tippers will go and pick sand to supply to construction company. That was how Ojukwu built his resources. If he had wanted to stay in the presidential world, he would have stayed, they would have feeding him. But the spirit that Igbo man is known for, that resilience, that enterprising spirit, did not allow him to go and depend on somebody to give him food. Remember, this man is a Cambridge University graduate, you know, of class. He stood down and was doing that business and began to raise money before he came back to Nigeria. So he didn't want to be a burden to Humphrey Gwaini or the people of Ivory Coast. That is the leader. That's his mindset. He doesn't want to be a problem to anybody. Rather, he wants people's problem to be his problem. I will put his neck on the line. He will put his father's wealth on the line. He will put his reputation on the line. He will put his life on the line for his people. And yet there were saboteurs who sabotaged Ojukwu. There's a man called Joey Bokwe, who is a commissioner in Lagos State government, was just talking trash that was coming out of his... Chineke Eba Aragime. Eba Hino Ni Okwoku Ni Epugide Ni Igbo. Ndi Awosa, Ndi Yoruba Ni Okwoku, Na Hende Fulani Ni Eme, Adige Maki Nwa Nwo Ni Igbo, Maki Hine Emere Gi Commissioner Na Lagos State. Anyway, you're not important. Let me discuss other things. So, what I'm trying to say is this. When Ojukwu came back, when he was given pardon, I was at Aba Stadium when Ojukwu was addressing the crowd. I've been following this life from childhood. And because of Awolowo's advice, it didn't get lost on Ojukwu, even though Ojukwu respected Awolowo as a good economist, a good financial manager. He said that Awolowo was the best president Nigeria never had. But he also made mention of the fact that the Yoruba man has become too Yoruba, he has forgotten he's in Nigeria. So in actual fact, the people who really wanted one Nigeria to progress were the Igbos, as everybody knows. And then there was a systematic execution of a program to see that the Igbo man does not exceed a particular level in the military. If you want to get, in fact, cut off point into the university in Igbo land was so high, while that of the north, they could even give you just 9.9. If you get 9 points, you're okay. Sometimes even at 7, they were doing educational disadvantaged states. I don't know how that became our fault. Where you enthrone mediocrity over merit. That is what you get in Nigeria today. And we did our best to see that this country stands. It has been failing, even though we were disadvantaged from every position. Our people paid for it, believed in it. They never gave them a chance. Igbos, you should be wise. Dele Momodu came and was talking. He said that actually he highlighted things that there should be one Nigeria. He believes that Buhari knows what to do. He was talking about Pastor Ighodalo, his very good friend. What Ighodalo said is nothing new to what Nnamdi Kanu has been saying since 10 years ago. Go and look at the prophetic utterance he gave, which is in the social media. Why is he advertising that of Ighodalo or Ighodalo now? Is the truth coming from him? Nnamdi Kanu had said it long ago. Even you, the Igbo man, didn't believe it. It is only now believed because Dele Momodu is saying it, that it comes from his friend. And then as he's talking it, he's there looking for a hope of one Nigeria and then asking, why shouldn't Biafrans agitate for Biafra, seeing that they have been marginalized? No, we are not dealing on issues where you bring Nigeria by the side and put Biafra. This is, our project is Biafra. And Biafra also means we are telling other, in a in a kind of a concept that has the concept that has a local pigmentation that is going to take an international coloration. Biafra now goes beyond the Biafra region. It's an ideology that talks about liberating other people that are in bondage, but it starts from us, whom God has given the light. So when we make people understand the need for them to be liberated from political subjection, economic subjection, mental subjection, we want people to be free. That's why when Nnamdi is talking, he's telling the middle belt, wake up. Yorubas, wake up. The Hausas, wake up. Igbos, wake up. People should use your brain. When he was talking about unity of Nigeria. I was also arguing the case of Biafra. No. No, sir. Mr. Dele Mumodu. Look, I'm not here to challenge you. No. I'm also 61 years old. The point is that, yeah, I agree you have traveled so many places in the whole world, taking honors with this man that has this computer, is it Xenox or Linux, whatever they call him, and all those people you took, Emekwalia, thank God for you. The issue on ground is not the accolades you have received internationally. We're talking about Biafra, the liberation of our people. The spirit to liberate people dwells in Nnamdi Kanu. That is why he has gone beyond this recognition of what somebody has achieved on a personal level. Even though I know Dele was saying it, you know, to counter whoever was talking to him on chat there. But at that point, he was also telling you that he is a force to reckon with. We are not interested in that, because if Nnamdi Kanu wanted to be recognized, he's an intelligent guy, based on his intellect and what he has read, his background, the school he went, he would have not talked about Biafra. He would have been doing his business and making his money, get all the recognition everywhere in the whole world, and still come to Nigeria a big guy. But true to who he is as a leader, he has jettisoned all these things. If all that Nnamdi Kanu wants is liberation of the Biafran people. He's not interested. Whatever he's using his academics to do is for the sensitization of his people, opening their eyes. And not just his people, those that are in the surrounding communities, like the Yoruba people. It is what he has been doing that has culminated into what's going on Igboho is doing today. Nnamdi Kanu has been like an eye-opener. And so anybody that is talking on Facebook that does not bring the Biafra project in focus and begin to tell about Nigeria. Remember, Bishop Kuka said that thing before. And Nnamdi Kanu, I even wrote against what Kuka said. Even before Nnamdi Kanu said, I looked into it, I told him, Kuka is talking about one Nigeria. We're talking about Biafra. One Nigeria is not a project. Nigeria is not working. You Yorubas, you know Nigeria is not working. You know, Minu Beltanas, you people, they have overrun your land. Autumn came up already. Dele Mumodu was saying that Autumn is supposed to be a professor. What? For giving information of what he heard? What do you want to talk about a professor? Somebody who is a think tank. Nnamdi Kanu is a think tank. All by himself. He thinks out and begins to tell you things. And he was praising Autumn, the governor of a state, who has enjoyed from the milk of Nigeria. He has a security vote. They killed his people. Now, it's just now that Autumn is waking up. Because if he had woken up, if he had woken up earlier, he would have been talking with Nnamdi Kanu long before now. If they hadn't killed the Benue people, if they hadn't killed people from Plateau State, this man wouldn't be talking. They would be looking at Igbos as rebels. But Ugwa Ometitola, because Igbo Zomo knows what the Congo cable until Mwagi now. And it pains me that an Igbo man will see and hear all this and begin to talk trash. Anybody that comes up and begin to, praise Biafra and then bring Nigeria to you, say, hey, God bless you, brother, I did the right thing. You cannot decipher between the lines and read that. No, what's going on? It's annoying me. And for information, we are not interested in all those people who are, if you're a medical doctor in America, continue your course, in your duty. Whenever Biafra is realized, you can go home and practice medicine. There are those that are designed to build the hospitals which you work. Let them stay in their own lane. Don't go and interfere into the Eastern Security Network and try to call the commander. You compromise the security position, and Nnamdi Kanu said it. You see how intelligent that young man is?
Thank you for watching that video. And guys, before you leave, don't forget to subscribe See you guys in my next video.